everyone. Dylan Schumacher, Citadel Defense, and we're back with a weird wide angle because I'm about to pan the camera down because I have my poncho laid out with all my gear on it. And this is my loadout video for SNS Training Solutions. I won to the privilege to go to one of their courses here as part of my participation in the Brent 500,000 subscriber video contest. I got second place in that, and so I get to go to the SNS Training Solutions as kind of my prize, well, not kind of my prize, for winning that class. So this is my loadout video for what I am bringing to that class. Full disclaimer, I've never been. I based this off the gear list, plus added some extra things that I wanted to bring. Don't know if any of it's legit or not legit. This is just what I'm bringing. So, you know, this is to give you ideas again. This is not, you can't show up and say, well, Dylan told me to bring this. That's not true at all. This just gives you an idea of what you can bring, or at least what I'm bringing. So, hope this is helpful, and hope you find this loadout for a couple days of patrol, small unit tactics training helpful. So here we go. Okay, first things first. This is my ruck. This is a DG3 ruck from Crossfire that I will be bringing. Inside, I have a bunch of different dry bags of different sizes to accommodate gear as needed. This is just the lid that's detached for now. And then I have attached four Black Hawk pouches along the outside here, just for additional loadouts and gear. My bedroll here, which is just the thermal rest, I just have strapped to the bottom here. And then on the sides, I have two one-quart canteens. So I have one here, one on the other side, and this one has a cup in it. The other one does not, because obviously you only need one cup. This is a 55-liter pack, and this will be my ruck if we have to do any kind of overnighting or any kind of long-range patrolling at the class. Up next, sleep stuff. So this is a bivy bag. This is an Army Surplus bivy bag that's all rolled up here. And then this is my sleeping bag. This is a Recon sleeping bag. This is the Recon 3 Gen 2. It says it's down good down to 23 degrees Fahrenheit. It's supposed to get down to 30 while I'm there, so it'll probably be pretty cold, but I have that. I have some extra layers to try to sleep comfortably. This is a jungle blanket from Snug Pack. I'm bringing this in addition so that, again, when I'm at base camp, I don't have to freeze and I can be warm and happy. So I've broken this down into two pieces, things that are going to go in my ruck, and then things that are going to go in my kind of camp tote bag over there that we'll get to. So I'll try to note what goes where as we move through things. This is a 1 gallon dirty water bag that I pair with my water filter. I probably won't put this in my ruck unless I know I'm going to need it, but I am going to bring it in the event that I need it. I do have my water filter. It's over there in my fighting load, and we'll get to that part. This is just a simple little field repair kit that fixes anything that breaks with my DG3. It's what came with it, and so I just always keep it with that bag in case something breaks. This is a small little fire starter kit. I got some matches, a lighter, and some tinder in here. Doubt I'm gonna need this, but again, that always just kind of rides my long range patrol bag, so it just stays in here. This is a Dark Angel Medical Ouch Pouch. It's just a boo-boo kit. So band-aids, gloves, some small medicines, just, you know, little boo-boo stuff that you may or may not need if you get cut, scrapes, or whatever. This is an e-tool, because you always need that. This is my cartridge kit. I made a couple notes of things I'm missing. Like, I'll have toothpaste, toothbrush, soap, or deodorant in here yet, but I need to add that. But right now, it's got foot powder, mouthwash, Leuco tape. That's essential. That's great. Stops blisters. Great for cut, scrapes, whatever. And then chapstick. This is a rifle cleaning kit. Not sure if I'm actually gonna need this or not, probably won't, but I have the rod in here in case I need to take care of stuck casings, and then just a rag to wipe everything off with. This is a multicam pack cover. Will not go over this pack with this bedroll attached, but if I ever need to stash my pack for a while or bed down or whatever, I can always use this to protect the pack from rain and further camouflage it. This is just a schmog, it's green schmog because that's always useful. Down here, I have what I call my rifle kit, meaning that when you go to these classes, you know, you get issued a class rifle, right, because it's all with blanks and miles gear. And so this is stuff to attach to my rifle to make my life a little bit better, a little bit easier. So first off, I have a T-Rex arm sling, because I like to have a nice sling. I have some quick detach mechanisms on here already. I also have a couple of hooks. I forget what these are called, clasp hook things. There's a name for these, but I forget what they're called. And that's, of course, to, you know, attach anywhere it needs attaching. I got a bunch of I have a bunch of zip ties in here for zip tying various stuff. I have a barrel clamp with a piece of Picatinny in case there's not a good spot to put my light on. I have a light. I have a laser. This is a D2 from Steiner. This is my laser that I took off my gun and I'm bringing. And then I have a MRO on a co-witness mount that I plan on throwing on the gun, so I have some kind of optic that I can run with. I also have electrical tape in here, some duct tape, some cap crap, and a lens cleaner. Just again, stuff to care for and upgrade my issued rifle so that it can be more comfortable for me without making any, you know, major modifications. Down here we have our cooking kit. So this is just a Fire Dragon stove with 3 fuel cells, a lighter wrapped in duct tape, and then a lid and a rag. This gets paired with the cup, you know, if I want to heat my food up or make some coffee or whatever, that goes in there. That goes in its own dry bag, so it all stays together. Here is my shelter kit. So I have a couple bungees. This is the bag for the poncho that everything is on right now. And that has some paracord in it and then some tent stakes so I can make a shelter out of this poncho. This is a little armboard thing, and I can put pieces of paper in here and make notes for like waypoints, time hacks, routes, anything like that that I need quick on hand, so that can just ride on your arm. Extra set of brown gloves. Here I have a bunch of hand warmers. It's supposed to get pretty cold while I'm there, actually. Like the high is like 50, 55 degrees, and the low is in 30 degrees, so I bring in a bunch of hand warmers. Wet wipes. I have another set of wet wipes over there with my fighting load, but this is my backup set of wet wipes. Eye protection, ear protection, not because I'm going to need it, but because in case I don't want to run my helmet during the day or whatever, but I still want to have my radio on, I can plug my radio into here, so that way it stays sneaky quiet. Writing in the rain, notepad, and pen. Down here, I have a bunch of snivel gear. I have a waffle top. I'm not sure where my waffle bottoms are right now. I gotta try to find those before I leave. I have a little silk green neck gaiter thing. Equix 2 neck gaiter. Watch cap. Green fleecy thing, which I might throw out. This is kind of a duplicate on the Equix deal, so that might not be going with. Long underwear, tops and bottoms. Smart wool top. And another smart wool top. That's all gonna go in this little packing cube to keep all my snivel gear together. Moving down here, I have an Gore-Tex top and bottom in multicam, a woodland poncho, so you have to have 2 uniforms, woodland and then multicam. So this is my rain gear for woodland. This is a bunch of socks and underwear. This is a Camelback water carrier. My main plan is to run this yoke pack back over here. However, if for whatever reason I can't run that or whatever, I'm bringing this just in case I just need to run water somehow, and that's how I'll run it. Back here I have a woodland jacket, semi-water resistant. It's also insulated, so it'll probably be perfect for the weather I'm going into. And then this is a sniper veil, which is kind of this tan green on one side, and on the other side it's a woodland like pattern. For boots, I have Gore-Tex Rats boots. Again, it's gonna be cold, possibly raining. These would be perfect for that environment. Up here, I have my fighting load. So this is a Eagle Industries yoke pack. I have a 3-liter bladder that's in the yoke pack, and then my helmet is in here right now that I'll mount my night vision to if we get to have that kind of fun time. Also in here, I have a red headlamp right here. And then I also have a camo face paint back here. On the side, I have my field knife. That's just for, you know, field craft tasks, stuff like that. Things that will go in the fight pack are some biodegradable wipes, because those are always important. A compass with a set of pace count beads. My GPS will be in here as well. A small boo-boo kit. A bunch of bits that pair with my multi-tools so that if anything comes loose or comes off, I can fix it in the field. A little lens wipe in case my glasses get dirty or whatever. A bottle of lube. A lighter with duct tape. A unopened package of paracord. I'll have to open this before I go so I don't have to deal with the trash. A lens cloth. A bunch of different batteries, CR123s, AAAs, and AAs to keep all my electronics and toys running. A a water filter, as well as water purification tablets, and then a small dirty water bag in order to capture water and run through my filter. On the list, they have a blade, like a folder, so that is what I will have. I'll run this in my pocket. I'm bringing a small orange signaling panel, just because that's always a good idea to have that in case you need to do any near recognition symbols or signals or whatever. This is an IFAC, it's a Dark Angel IFAC that I have put inside a military surplus IFAC insert that will go in here. I'll probably just run this as a dangler to my chest rig, and then I have a tourniquet underneath there. For my chest rig, I just got the Onward Research chest rig. Haven't played with it at all yet, excited to run it out there. So I have that, and then this is my radio on the side here. I have a little bit larger antenna to swap out with the stubby antenna, depending on what's most appropriate for what I'm trying to accomplish. I have night vision, this is my PDS-14. This is thermal, I haven't played with this at all yet. Excited to run that down there and find out more about how thermal works. Lastly, I have two sets of uniforms. So this is my multicam set, tops, bottoms, a couple t-shirts, and then this is my Arctis multicam knockoff parka that I plan on running if it gets windy, cold, whatever. It's a great piece of kit, I love that thing. Highly recommend that Arctis smock. If you've watched this channel, you've seen that before, that thing's great. And then this is my woodland set of uniform. Again, gloves, top, bottom, t-shirts, boonie hat, all the kind of basic uniform stuff. This is my field tote bag that all the stuff will go in that I'm not taking out to the field, right, that I'm saving at base camp. That'll stay here in this field tote bag. And last, but certainly not least, a notebook to take notes. Because when I go to classes, I try to take as many notes as humanly possible. Okay, well, I hope that was helpful. I hope that gives you an idea. Even as I made this video, I definitely noted down a couple things that I'm missing. Like I want to bring a camp chair. I'm certainly missing some toiletries. I hope to find those waffle bottoms because it'd be nice to have those for sleeping at night. But this is, in general, what I am going to be bringing. So, again, I hope this gives you ideas. That's the point of these videos. Not to go out and carbon copy it, right? But to say, oh, that's a nice thing I should have, or that's a good thing I should have, or if you've never done this before, to give you an idea of the breadth of stuff that you should have. So, hope that gives you ideas. Hope that was informative. Do brave deeds and endure.